Hello students, and welcome back to a new class of analog electronics. In this class we are going to study about oscillators and a portion of amplifier, RC coupled amplifier. So first we will study about oscillator and then we will study about amplifier. So let us first start this. In oscillator portion, we are going to cover introduction of oscillator. We need to know what an oscillator is. Linear oscillators, different types of oscillator we will study there. Wien bridge oscillator, RC phase shift oscillator, LC oscillator, and about their stability. So what is an oscillator? For knowing oscillators, we need to know what is oscillation. An effect that repeatedly and regularly fluctuates about the mean value, that is oscillation. Whenever a regular fluctuation is being there, that particular thing is oscillation, and one circuit that produces oscillation is the oscillator. Now the oscillation characteristics can be of different types. It may be wave shape, frequency, amplitude, distortion, stability, anything. What are the application of oscillators? Oscillators are used to generate signals. Like it's used as a local oscillator to transform the RF signal to IF signals in a receiver, used to generate RF carrier in a transmitter, used to generate clocks in digital system, used as switch circuits in PV cells and CRO. Linear oscillators, as we have already said, these are Wien bridge oscillator, RC shift oscillator, and LC oscillator. So in integrant of linear oscillator, here you can see this is a positive feedback system. Here input voltage is coming and the feedback is also there. And the error signal, the difference of these two, the summation of these two will be amplified to the output, and the portion will feedback to the frequency, selective feedback network. For sinusoidal input, our input is connected linear because the output is approximately sinusoidal. A linear oscillator contains a frequency selection feedback network, an amplifier to maintain the loop gain at unity. Basic linear oscillator. This is the circuit of basic linear oscillator, where this is the feedback gain beta F and this is the system gain AF. We can say output equal to A into input voltage. Input is here beta E. So beta E, now what is beta E? Beta E is the sum of Vs and Vf. So A into Vs plus Vf. And beta F is the beta into Vz. So V, 0 by Vs, output by input can be written as A by A minus 1 minus A beta. If Vs equal to 0, the only way that V0 can be non-zero is that loop gain A beta equal to 1, which implies that A beta equal mod of A beta equal to 1 and angle of A beta equal to 0. And this particular criteria where the magnitude is 1 but the angle is 0, this is known as Barkhausen criteria. Next is RC phase shift oscillator. This is an oscillator circuit where input using an inverting amplifier, the additional 180 degree phase shift is provided by an RC phase shift network. Now if we apply KVL to the circuit, we can write V1 equal to 1 minus R minus JXC minus I2 into R. I1 into R minus JXC minus I2 into R. Similarly, for both these capacitors, there is no supply voltage. So 0 equal to the KVL equation and 0 equal to the third KVL equation. Now for solving this using Cramer's rule, we get the value of I3. The output voltage. Output voltage will be V into R3, I3 into R. So put the value of I3 and calculate it with R. So you can get the output voltage. Hence the transfer function, it will be output by input. LC oscillator, the frequency selection network. LC oscillator is a frequency selection network where Z1, Z2 and Z3 provides a phase shift of 180 degrees. The amplifier provides an addition shift of 180 degrees. Two well-known oscillators are called pitch oscillator and Harley oscillator. So these are the LC oscillator. Here VF can be written as beta V0. In space of beta, we can write Z1 by Z1 plus Z3. This part is not required. Hartley, yeah. These two are Hartley oscillators and Colpitts oscillators. So Hartley oscillator here, a series of inductor is connected as a potential divider with resistor. And here a series of capacitor is been connected with the R and L. Here omega 0 equal to 1 by root over L1 plus L2 into C. And for Colpitts, omega 0 equal to 1 by root over L into Ct, where Ct is the C1, C2 by C1 plus C2. It is the equivalent circuit. It is assumed that linear small signal model of transistor is used. The transistor capacitances are neglected. Input resistance of the transistor is large enough. Frequency stability. The frequency stability of an oscillator is defined as 1 by omega d omega dt. The use of high stability capacitor, example silver, mica, polystyrene or teflon capacitors, and low temperature coefficient inductors for high stable oscillators. Amplitude stability. In order to start the oscillation, the loop gain is usually slightly greater than unity. LC oscillators in general do not require amplitude stabilization circuits because of the selectivity of the LC circuits. In RC oscillators, some nonlinear devices, example NPC, PTC resistor, FET or Zener diodes can be used to stabilize the amplitude. This is Wien bridge oscillator with bulb stabilization. Here bulb is kept as a load and the circuit is for Wien bridge circuit. And this is for diode stabilization. So two anti-parallel connection of Zener diode is there. And this is the Wien bridge oscillator with diode stabilization. Wien T oscillator. See two T connection, two low pass filters in T model. One low pass filter, one high pass filter in T model has been connected with the oscillator, and this is known as Wien T oscillator. Bistable circuit. This is the circuit symbol of bistable. Square wave oscillator. This is similar to a Smith trigger, except that the capacitor is being used over here. This is a square wave oscillator. Now amplifier. So far we have studied about oscillator. Now the oscillator provides the oscillation waveform, and to get the oscillating signal, sometimes the signal may be of very small, very few range. So to get a proper signal, we need to amplify that. So before studying RC coupled amplifier, let us know first what is an amplifier. Amplification is the process of increasing the signal strength by increasing the amplitude of a given signal without changing its characteristics. The input signal may be a current signal, voltage signal, or a power signal. Amplifier will amplify the signal without changing its characteristics. Application of amplifier are of wide range. They are mainly used in communication, controller, audio and video instruments, etc. An amplifier which is commonly based on transistor is basically known as transistor amplifier. The input signal may be a current signal, voltage signal, or a power signal. An amplifier will amplify the signal without changing its characteristics, and the output will be a modified version of the input. Application of amplifier are of wide range. They are mainly used in audio and video instrument, communication controller, etc. Single stage common emitter amplifier. A single stage common emitter RC coupled amplifier is a simple and elementary amplifier circuit. The main purpose of this circuit is pre-amplification, that is to make weak signal to be stronger enough for further amplification, that I have already told you. If designed properly, this RC coupled amplifier can provide excellent signal characteristics. Single stage common emitter amplifier circuit. This is a circuit diagram of common emitter amplifier. The circuit Cin, the capacitor Cin at the input acts as a filter which is used to block the DC voltage and allow only AC voltage to the transistor. If any external DC voltage reaches the base of the transistor, it will alter the biasing condition and affect the performance of the amplifier. So they are talking about this capacitor. Next, about this biasing resistor. R1, R2 are resistor used for providing proper biasing to bipolar transistor. R1 and R2 form a biasing network which provides necessary base voltage to drive the transistor in active region. The region between cutoff and saturation is known as active. The region where the bipolar transistor operation is completely switched off is known as cutoff region, and the region where the transistor is completely switched on is known as saturation region. Resistor RC and RE are used to drop voltage of VCC. Resistor RC are a collector resistor and RE is emitter resistor. Both are selected in such a way that both should drop VCC voltage by 50% in the above circuit. The emitter capable CE and emitter resistor RE makes a negative feedback for making the circuit operation more stable. This is two-stage emitter amplifier. When input AC signal is applied to the base of the transistor of the first stage of RC coupled amplifier from the function generator, it is then amplified across the output of the first stage. This amplified voltage is applied to the base of next stage of the amplifier through the coupling capacitor Cout, where it is further amplified and reappears across the output of the second stage. Thus, the successive stages amplify the signal and the overall gain is raised to desired level. Much higher gain can be obtained by connecting a number of amplifier stages in succession. Resistance capacitance coupling in amplifiers are most widely used to connect the output of first stage to the input of the second stage and so on. This type of coupling is most popular because it is cheap and provides a constant amplification over a wide range of frequencies. Now, transistor as amplifier. While knowing about different circuits for RC coupled amplifier, it is important to know about transistor basics as amplifier. The three configuration of the bipolar transistors that are commonly used are common base, common emitter, and common collector. Other than transistors, operational amplifiers can also be used for amplification purpose. Common emitter configuration is commonly used in the audio amplifier application because common emitter has a gain that is positive and also greater than unity. In this configuration, emitter is connected to ground that has high input impedance. Output impedance will be minimum. Most of these types of transistor amplifier applications are commonly used in RF communication and optical fiber communication. Common base configuration has a gain less than unity. In this configuration, collector is connected to ground. We have low output impedance and high input impedance in common base configuration. Common collector configuration is known, also known as emitter follower, because the input applied to the common emitter appears across the output of the common collector. In this configuration, collector is connected to ground. It has low output impedance and high input impedance. It has a gain almost equal to unity. Basic parameters of a transistor amplifier. A good amplifier must have all the following specification. It should have high input impedance. It should have high stability. It must have high linearity. It should have high gain and bandwidth. It must have high efficiency. Bandwidth. The range of frequency that an amplifier circuit can amplify properly is known as the bandwidth of that particular amplifier. The curve represents the frequency response of a single stage RC coupled amplifier that we will see later. The curve which represents the variation of gain of an amplifier with frequency is called frequency response curve. The bandwidth is measured between the lower half power and upper half power point that you have also read in your resonance chapter of circuit theory. T1 point is lower half power and P2 is upper half power respectively. A good audio amplifier must have a bandwidth from 20 Hz to 20 kHz because that is the frequency range which is audible. Gain. It's an gain of an amplifier is defined as the ratio of output power to the input power. Gain can be expressed either in decibel or in number. Gain represents how much an amplifier is able to amplify a signal given to it. The equation represents gain in number, Pout by PE, where Pout is the output power of an amplifier and Pin is the input power of an amplifier. The equation below represents gain in decibel, where gain in decibel equal to log 10 log Pout by PE. Gain can also be expressed in voltage and current. Gain in voltage is ratio of output voltage to the input voltage, and gain in current is the ratio of output current to the input current. Equation for gain in voltage and current can be shown here. Gain in voltage will be output voltage by input, and gain in current will be always gain will be output by input, whatever the term is. High input impedance. Input impedance is the impedance which is offered by an amplifier circuit when it is connected to the voltage source. The transistor amplifier must have high input impedance in order to prevent it from loading the input voltage source. So that is the reason for having high impedance in the amplifier. Noise refers to unwanted fluctuation or frequencies present in a signal. It may be due to the interaction between two or more signals present in a system, component failure, design flaws, external interference, or maybe by virtue of certain components used in the amplifier circuit. Linearity. An amplifier is said to be linear if there is any linear relationship between the input power and the output power. Linearity represents the flatness of the gain. Practically, it's not possible to get 100% linearity as the amplifiers uses active devices like BJT, JFET, MOSFET, which tend to lose gain at high frequencies due to internal parasitic capacitance. In addition to this, the input DC decoupling capacitors sets a lower cutoff frequency. Efficiency of an amplifier represents how an amplifier can utilize the power supply efficiently and also measure how much power from the power supply is gainfully converted at output. Efficiency is usually expressed in percentage, and the equation for efficiency is given as Pout by PS into 100, where Pout is the output power and PS is the power drawn from power supply. A class A transistor amplifier has 25% efficiency and provides excellent signal reproduction, but the efficiency is very low. Class C has efficiency up to 95%, but the signal reproduction is bad. Class AB stands in class A and class C amplifiers, so it is commonly used in audio amplifier application. This has efficiency up to 55%. Slew rate of an amplifier is the maximum rate of change of output per unit time. It represents how rapidly the output of an amplifier can be changed in response to change in the input. Stability is the capacity of an amplifier to resist oscillation. Usually, stability problem occurs during high frequency operation, close to 20 kHz in case of audio amplifier. The oscillation may be of high or low amplitude. Now, amplification is a process of increasing the signal strength by increasing the amplitude of a given signal without changing its characteristics. An RC coupled amplifier is a part of a multi-stage amplifier wherein different stages of amplifiers are connected using a combination of resistor and a capacitor. An amplifier circuit is one of the basic circuits in electronics. So, my dear students, we have studied a lot in this particular chapter, right? So, go through this video more than once, go through this video thoroughly because you have studied two different things, an oscillator first and then amplifier. So, go through the part by part so that if any doubt arises, you can mention that in the comment section. So, thank you for watching the video. Thank you.